Episode 2311, Do Whatever It Takes.
Moms, it's time to rediscover, rejuvenate, and renew who you are in mind, body, and spirit. Welcome to Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie, the show to help you do just that. Here's your host, certified life coach, personal trainer, and nutritionist, Christiane Wargo.
Staring at a stop sign, watching people drive by.
Happy every day. I hope you're having a beautiful weekend. It is Relationship Builders, and you know what? I am on the move. Maybe you hear a little bit of an echo, because actually, I know I'm in the bathroom recording just for you. It's Relationship Builders. Are you ready for a story? Do whatever it takes. For those of you who are brand new to Create You Now, welcome to this incredible family. I'm so delighted of your presence. If you already didn't have the opportunity, you'll want to head on over to createyournow.com, where you can learn more and sign up for the Kisses newsletter, the Keep It Simple strategy, everyday solutions to live, love, and impact. Well, this episode is brought to you by the AIM Academy. If you only notice what you know, then you will never see what needs to be known. Do whatever it takes. Your presence in your marriage should always be top of mind. But we can get lost in the piles of laundry, the beeping timer that dinner's done, the screaming children begging for our attention, not to mention the bills and career demands. Life keeps moving at a speed where it's hard to slow down. However, when you are in a committed relationship, when you're in a marriage, slowing down and noticing your sweetheart is vital. It's essential. My husband had to go out of town this weekend. He had planned to take one of the kiddos with him, but they really weren't too excited about the trip. It was one excuse after another. Instead of having a child go and be fussy the whole time, I suggested that I go. Hence the echo that you hear now. Yes, I am recording as you're listening. Okay, not exactly in the bathroom, but you know what? You got to do what you got to do, right? Do whatever it takes. So my sweet hubby, he was really surprised that I would even suggest it. Now, that might surprise you a little bit, but you see, our daughter and grandbaby are visiting. And of course, he knows how much I want to spend time with them. But I also want to spend time with him. We all have sacrifices in life, and sometimes we have to make tough choices. But in marriage, if you really want to have a strong marriage, a strong relationship, you got to do whatever it takes. That is your Kiss to Keep It Simple strategy. We were not going to be gone for the entire weekend. And my daughter and grandbaby, yes, my little mini, was still going to be there a few days more after we returned. So why wouldn't I go spend some time with my husband and support him? Now, I do understand this, though. Some spouses would have taken the short road and stayed home for mere convenience. What would you have done? Think about it. Because you see, we shortchange our own marriage. And that becomes our problem because we get in the way. We want our stuff first all the time. And sometimes we have to put things in and on the back burner. It just has to go away for a moment because something else matters. More importantly, someone else matters. Who are you committed to? Are you committed to your selfish desires? Are you committed to the person that you said, I do? It's a tough choice at times, I know, because we can get fussy as adults. You think kids get fussy and they throw temper tantrums? Oh, no, no, no. Adults throw worse temper tantrums. Just look, driving on the highway, going to work, right? You see it all the time. Road rage. You turn on the news and what happens? It's one thing after another, a fight, a shooting. We have a hard time as adults. Yet we don't understand why our kids can't understand, because what are they seeing every day modeled? We as married, committed adults need to be the role models for what needs to happen in our communities. We need to bond together first so then we can go out and impact the world that we touch. So when you're committed, you got to do whatever it takes. One way of doing that is to put on new eyes. Every morning, ask yourself, ask God and say, Lord, give me new eyes to see something new in my spouse. something good in my spouse. Maybe you're kind of stuck on the bad right now. All you see is negative, negative, negative. I know you got seasons of those. I get it. It's called life. And you're going to have your ups and downs in a marriage. But you also can be a determined individual and ask God and say, you know what? Put on new eyes for me. Every single morning, let me see something fresh, invigorating, that allows me to see the heart of my spouse, the one that I said I want to spend the rest of my life with and live happily ever after. But if you're fussy and selfish, you're never going to see that. So put on new eyes. Number two, know what is going on. I knew the schedule this weekend. I knew my husband was going out of town. I knew things were happening, and we had already discussed that he would take a child, and that was fine. But when the kids were like, oh man, we just got done with finals, we're tired. My other son was just coming off of a long work week, really long hours. And then of course, my daughter and grandbaby, of course, that wouldn't be a relaxful weekend. I mean, my husband loves his grandbaby, don't get me wrong. But if he's going away on a mission for business, well, sometimes it's best to go without little interruptions. And he's still little. He's just a little seven-monther. And he is so cute. Okay, I digress. So back on to what we're talking about, right? Know what is going on. And because I knew that already in my head, I had already thought, you know what? If the kids don't want to go, I can go. It's not a big deal. We'll be gone for a little while and then we'll come right back and, you know, little Minnie will still be there and my daughter will be too. And so we can enjoy that time. Put on new eyes. Know what is going on. And number three, be present. Too much of our life is spent just wandering. We're just reacting to the world. I really want you to take a hard look at the energy and the effort that you're putting into your marriage, because I really believe that if we can change the way we interact with our spouse, we can 100% change the world, because it starts within our own four walls. When you are committed, do whatever it takes. Remember, if you only notice what you know, then you will never see what needs to be known. Your spouse wants to be known to you. They want to be seen. They want to be heard. So see them. Hear them. Know that, yes, this is where I'm supposed to be. And yeah, maybe on a weekend you'll find yourself recording a podcast episode in the bathroom. And guess what? That's okay. It's called real life. And I love my life. Is it a little crazy all the time? 100%. That's why I say it's a party every day. But that doesn't mean that I don't have joy in my heart, even when it gets crazy. I just have to take a deep breath and be present. And that's what I ask you today. I want to challenge you to really hone in on your presence. If you're watching a game on TV, if you're snuggling on the couch, if you're watching a movie, whatever you're doing, be all in and present. I promise you, it will change the way you see things. Go out, be present, be incredible, be you. I love you so very much. I cannot wait to see you on the other side. Blessings, hugs, and lots of love. We'll talk to you real soon. Have a glorious day. Bye-bye.
Feeling inspired, ready to train for life, and love your journey? Visit createyournow.com for more incredible resources to help you along the way. We'll see you next time on Create Your Now, Your Best Selfie. And remember, always be sure you consult your physician before beginning any health and fitness plan.